in the darkest hour, when I cannot breathe, fear is on my chest, the weight of the world on me. Everything's crashing down, everything I have known. When I wonder if I'm all alone, I remember.
Watched in horror as the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001 left nearly 3,000 people dead in New York City, Washington, D.C., and Shakesville, Pennsylvania. And I'm sure those of us who experienced it can remember vivid details of the day's security and peace changed forever. And these terroristic attacks only made us, the American people, stronger and more resolute in our fight for peace and prosperity. And so on this 21st anniversary, we, the Connectional Young Adult Ministry of the Christian Methodist Episcopal Church, pause to remember those who lost their lives, their families who still grieve, and the heroes who fought and continue to fight the good fight in our place. And so with that being said, let us pray. Dear God, as we come to you humbly to reflect on this tragic day, we pray that you will still or continue to be the soft voice that whispers to the families who lost a loved one that you still love them and that you're still with them and that you will continue to encourage us all. We thank you for the heroes who indeed were courageous enough to put their lives on the line and who were willing to put up a fight for the sake of freedom and democracy. So God, we love you and we thank you. We reflect on this day. Amen.
Always there.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure.
The heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us.
Are you ready to get energized about civic engagement? Now is the time to do good in the hood by sharing our collective voices and votes to shape the midterm elections. The Connectional Young Adult Ministry, in partnership with the College of Bishops and the Conference of National Black Churches, is excited to present Operation 41, Voter Engagement Campaign.
Good afternoon. I am Marvin Frank Thomas, Senior Presiding Bishop of the First Episcopal District of the Christian Methodist Episcopal Church. Now is the time for us to come together in the band of Christian love, to be the drum majors of justice, and to get into some good trouble. Together we can ensure a brighter future for our nation, especially the local communities in which we live, work, and worship. This partnership will allow us to use our resources to help one another be successful. When we work together, it brings to life the words of the biblical text, which says, "Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man what wondrous things we can accomplish." Christian Methodist Episcopal Church, let's do this together. Let us together be drum majors for justice as we move forward into the working call the midterm elections 2022. God bless you. See you at the polls, or see you on your way to the polls. God bless. Thanks.
Operation 41 is a multifaceted operation with the focus on voter engagement and civic participation. In the spirit of the 41 who gathered in Jackson, Tennessee to do the will and the work of God, we, their loyal sons and daughters, also gather to rekindle the flame of social justice and equality through this voter engagement campaign.
We cannot continue to sit idly by in our living museums we call places of worship or church and watch the community and world around us perish. We must speak up, educate our people, and perform the actions necessary for us to bring about a positive change. Now is the time for us to be Psalms 82 people, defenders of the rights of the poor and the orphans, being fair to the needy and the helpless, rescuing them from the power of the wicked.
We can accomplish this task by getting our members and community actively engaged in voter activity and civic participation through three particular tasks: voter registration, general election knowledge, and grassroots efforts.
Registering to vote is the first step at achieving our goal. Elections are our chance to be heard. When we register to vote, this gives us an advantage in shaping the future and direction of our society. We are encouraging each Episcopal district to work with local community partners to organize and execute a voter registration. This is the start of voter engagement.
The laws have changed the game in the election process. It is our responsibility to make sure our communities are abreast of these laws and provide training and other resources to aid them in becoming knowledgeable voters. We are encouraging our congregations to share voting laws applicable to your state, to your membership.
It is not enough that we only do things through word, but we must also do in deed as well. We must create sustaining networks to share information and create lasting partnerships that focus on issues specific to our needs. When we connect people together, we bridge our congregations and communities to further advance our efforts. Church and faith leaders, let us spearhead the charge in creating these grassroots efforts to bring about the change we so desperately need.
Hey everybody, it's Pastor Zach here, and I know by now you're asking yourself the question, how can I get involved? It's quite simple, engaging your family and your friends. How do you do that? First of all, we invite you to share our weekly social media content to all of your followers and all of your friends. And secondly, get involved in your local community. In a time like this, we must walk it like we talk it. It's up to us to change the narrative. Listen. Now, what I want you to do is I want you to use your influence to change this world so that we can leave a better society for the next generation.
Now, I hope that we can count on you to make this campaign a success. It is our hope that this campaign not only impact the midterms, but also local and state elections in the future. We must take a vested interest in politics, and we cannot continue to allow others to speak for us. We must speak out. Thank you for sharing with us, and we look forward to hearing of the good trouble each of us get into.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours.